Hi guys, John Flores again, feeling a whole bunch better and really thrilled to tell you that I have some stories that I haven't told you yet regarding the Helen Reddy Project. This is insider stuff, very fun. I hope you enjoy it. From the early 70s to the late 70s, I perceived that there were two Helen Reddys. The early 70s through the mid 70s was the young woman coming from Australia, kind of naive and working her way up and becoming a spokesperson for women's liberation, etc. But she was kind of a really humble, very, very authentic human being, which is who she really was. By the time I got her in the late 70s, she was Americanized, she was a star, and she was very Brentwood, California, which is where she lived, you know, very upscale. And attitudinally, there's a difference. She was still warm and inviting and all of that when we sat around the piano and rehearsed and just chatted. She was just lovely. She was wonderful. But she was no longer the person that arrived a few years prior from Australia. Okay, she was more sophisticated. She had a different kind of feel, a different kind of aura about her. I'm not making any judgments, I'm just telling you kind of what I observed. So when we sat around the piano and went through material and decided what tunes to cut and which ones we'd discard, we agreed that there would be two sessions, a ballad session and a dance session. Okay, her husband Jeff Wald was her manager, and Jeff, based on the disco trend that was happening at the time, wanted me to cut some disco tracks on Helen Reddy, his wife. Well, okay. However, Helen Reddy doesn't really have the persona nor really the vocal style that fits well with disco. So what I did was I selected three songs that were, what would you call them? Pseudo-disco, almost disco, and what I would call polite disco. And that did match the sound of her voice and her delivery. Okay, so as you know from my previous video, when we went in and we cut the ballad dates, by the time the orchestration was on, Jeff was ready to fire me because he said that she sounded, and this is a direct quote, "You've made her sound like Percy fucking Faith," unquote. Okay, well, in fact, that was Darnielle's orchestrations, not the rhythm tracks or the black background singers or any of that. That was due to Darnielle's orchestrations. They were very Johnny Mathis-y because that's who Darnielle arranged and conducted for worldwide and on 7 albums prior to this. So yes, it was too sweet, and I offered Jeff the solution of just replacing the orchestra sessions that Darnielle did with Gene Page, the black arranger that I had used several times before, who would definitely make a difference on those ballad tracks. Okay, just a quick recap. Remember, I wasn't allowed in. I had already been fired, so I wasn't allowed to sit in on the vocal tracks or the final mixdowns of any of these sessions. And the reminder to you is my ongoing dispute with Let Me Be Your Woman that Helen sang, like the black background singers were singing, and also the full voice, full out, "Let me be your woman," on the choruses. Okay, so you're aware of that dispute. I wouldn't have had her do it. I would have had her saying woman instead of woman. What is news is that when Jeff threatened to fire me and then kind of went along and said, okay, you can do your disco rhythm date because it's already booked for 3 days from now and it's your songs and your rhythm section, your studio, your engineer, and your conductor, do the rhythm date for the disco tunes and then I'll decide whether I will fire you after that, but go ahead and do that date. So when I did, and by the way, Helen didn't show up for that date, for the rhythm date, all those black musicians, fabulous rhythm date. She said she threw her back out the night before while sleeping. Okay, doesn't matter whether that's true or not, but she was a no-show. I would surmise it was because I was kind of becoming persona non grata and was getting ready to be fired, and so she didn't want to be around me. That's my opinion. But we did the date. It was just terrific. And Jeff called at the end of the day after he had received the rough mix of the rhythm date and said, "You can continue. You're not fired yet." So I did. And so we tried to do the vocals, and I've told you about that, where I should have had her go back to her studio at Capitol with her engineer, her homeroom where her hits were recorded, and let her do her thing, because I couldn't get her to relax. But anyway, Jeff called and he said, you know, basically, "John, you're fired, thanks for the work. And by the way, this isn't quite disco, is it?" And I said, "No, Jeff, it's what I would call polite disco, because it matches Helen's style. So really hardcore disco, she isn't gonna cut it because it's just not what she does or who she is, but this she can do." And this is another direct quote. Jeff says to me, "Fuck polite, John, I want hits. I want disco hits." Okay, so long story short, I'm fired. Of the disco sessions that were released, only one cut made the cut, so to speak, and that was a tune called "You're So Good." Now, I brought her the tune, it's my rhythm date, it's my black background singers, and my whole feel that I thought was just perfect for Helen, and when she did the vocal without me, she did a great job, okay, wonderful job. The horrible mistake that happened with this track, other than the fact that it's mixed like shit, sorry, but it is that whoever arranged the horns for this date phoned it in or had no imagination whatsoever. They are horrible. Now, there are a couple of sections where they are acceptable, and I have used those now in my brand new remaster that I'm going to show you now. I'll post the entire thing underneath this particular video and you can hear it. But we're gonna do our normal thing and we're gonna do before and after, and you'll hear what was presented, meaning horrible horn licks and horrible mix. And we're gonna do it section by section, and I'm gonna show you what the final producer and engineer did versus what I did, okay? Hope you had fun with this. I sure had fun telling you. And as always, thanks for watching. You guys take care. Bye-bye.